We all know about the circadian rhythm, which controls our hunger and sleep cycles. There is one more rhythm in the body which is finer than the circadian rhythms. Let us now look into this. We must first understand the seven tissue types or dhatus in Ayurveda and a sequence related to them. Let us begin with the outermost covering of the body, namely the skin. The skin, along with muscles and ligaments, is associated with the Mamsa Dhatu. We can consider this Dhatu to be the first in a special sequence. We find fatty cells underneath the skin in all the muscles and the blood vessels in the body. Ayurveda attributes fatty cells to Medha Dhatu. We encounter a solid structure next, namely the bones. The bones belong to Asthi Dhatu. Bone marrow is lodged within the bones. This marrow is connected to Majja Dhatu. Majja Dhatu is homologous to the nervous system. Human genetic material is finer than the cells that form the nervous system. Shukra Dhatu in Ayurveda is associated with the reproductive system. Two more Dhatus come next. They both relate to cells which belong to circulating fluids. Lymphatic fluids are a part of Rasa Dhatu. The last in the sequence of Dhatus is Rakta Dhatu. It refers directly to blood, a major portion of which is water. The fast-flowing Rakta Dhatu is the carrier of the fire that invigorates the mind and the body. Vedic rishis saw the moon, the fastest moving luminary in the sky, to be the ruler of this Dhatu. Next to the moon in speed is Mercury. It influences the Rasa Dhatu. Next in speed is Venus, whose influence dominates over Shukra Dhatu. The sun moves slower than Venus in the sky. It does logically rules the nervous system, the Majja Dhatu. Martian influence can be seen in the strength of the bones or Asthi Dhatu. Jupiter rules over the unctuous fat tissues of Medha Dhatu. Saturn rules over the expansive covering of the body and the bulky mass of Mamsa Dhatu. Transformative fire or Agni in Ayurveda dominates in one Dhatu for an hour and moves to the next Dhatu as per the above sequence. It takes 7 hours for the energy of transformation to cycle back to the first Dhatu again. After three such cycles, this energy begins its fourth cycle within the 24-hour period. It completes the remainder of this cycle on the next day. Due to this, the Dhatu at the sunrise hour of 7 consecutive days follows a strange sequence. The planets corresponding to these sunrise hour Dhatus set the well-known weekday sequence in play. We experience the effect of several rhythms in existence, namely the cycle of seasons, the circadian cycle, the biophysical, psychological, and the biopsychic cycle. Understanding them gives us the ability to manage our mind and emotions.